Morning to viewers, the Colonel speaking to you live from the Grain for British Imperial YouTube Broadcasting. So we've got a Victor record, there we go. A talk on trusts, comic talk by Murray K. Hill. Here we go.
Well, I'm glad to see so many smiling faces here this evening, and I certainly feel happy myself. I just received a dispatch that my brother will not die. He will not die. We thought, sure, he's going to die next Friday, but the governor changed the sentence to life. But who is to blame for all of this? By the trust. So my subject this evening will be on the trust. I'm going to discount our wrongs, recut our rights, and cut the trust in general. Here we are in the greatest country in the United States and kicking about the high cost of living. Everything is going up. Even my brother is going up for life. I meant to say, who is to blame for all of this? Why, the trust. Now, take the Standard Oil Company, for instance. The Standard Oil Company. You know, it's terrible, the high price of food. And I was reading in this morning's paper that two burglars broke into John D. Rockefeller's, a home the other night. But the burglars are lucky. They were lucky burglars. They got out without losing anything. So I said to the other burglar, but who was to blame for all of this? Why, the trust? Now, take Pierpont Morgan, or Pierpont Morgan. You know, what did that man did? What had that man done? What did he? I'll tell you what he done. He tried to pass a law that the poor man should not eat only what his occupation calls for. Great immense. Can our baseball players live on nothing but fowls and flies? Can our pugilists exist on nothing but punches? Can our policemen eat nothing but forks, beets, and club sandwiches? Then they talk about reform. They want reform? Why don't they go to the women? They'll show them how to reform. But who's to blame for all of this? Why, the trust? Why, they were shipped into this country last year 8 million crates of lemons. And all lemons are so high right now, we hate to be handed a lemon. The manufacturers of lemons claim the reason lemons are so high is the vine is down, and you'll never see the lemon drop until it's raised. And talk about graft, now Congress is going to donate $2 million to give the lemonade. But who is to blame for all of this? Why, the trust? Now take the law of compensation, for instance. Maybe you don't know what I'm talking about, neither do I, so I'll explain. The law of compensation is if you lose one part of your anatomy, the other part will become stronger. For instance, if you have two strong eyes, you lose one eye will be as strong as the two eyes were before you lost the one, and you'll take just as big an eye opener in the morning. But not the state of Kansas. Or if your back is bent in the front of your back will be straighter than the back of your back. Or if you have two strong hands, you lose one hand, reaching for something you can't get. You know, my brother tried to do this, but he had to knock this guy down. I meant to say, if you have two short legs, you get one leg pulled, that leaves you with one short leg. Now then, if you have one short leg, the other leg is bound to be longer. But who's to blame for all of this? Why, the trust. Why, you know, still they say this world owes us a living. The world owes me a living. We should hurry up and pay me. I'm getting sick of working. Well, you know, I think I've told you about all the trust. The trust is the only thing that ruined this world, and so I'll bid you good night.
Well, as I suspected, viewers, that was indeed something to do with the Standard Oil troubles at the beginning of the last century now, of course, with Ida Tarbox, I seem to recall, was involved in it, and yes. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you, and goodbye.